It is Wednesday, April 24th, and the Expedition 35 crew on board the International Space Station has spent part of its day taking care of their own emergency preparedness, the rest of the day working on a range of scientific and technical experiments that are the heart of their mission of discovery. Flight engineers Pavel Vinogradov and Roman Romanenko have spent their afternoon disassembling the docking assembly of the Progress ship that's now docked to the station at the Pier's docking compartment. That vehicle is scheduled to stay at the station until July. In the meantime, a new Progress vehicle headed for the International Station launched this morning from the Baikonur Cosmodrome. That new Progress 51, launched on time this morning and is headed for an arrival at the station at 7:26 Houston time this Friday morning. Now, one of the antennas for the Kurs automated docking system did not deploy properly, and the Russian flight controllers are currently assessing their options while continuing with the engine firings that are refining the approach of the Progress vehicle to the space station. It's expected to arrive at the Zvezda aft docking port on Friday morning, and NASA TV and NASA.gov will have live coverage of the docking beginning at 6:45 a.m. Central Time. Today, Commander Chris Hadfield completed a lens change on the EarthCam camera, supporting another week of photography of targets all over the Earth taken by students from all around the globe. Hadfield then joined his crewmates for an emergency response drill, a routine practice for crews to periodically refresh themselves on how they respond to onboard emergencies. All of the crew members later took part in a conference with ground teams to evaluate the response of everyone involved. Hadfield also helped flight engineer Chris Cassidy with an ultrasound session, getting images of a variety of targets on Cassidy's body for study by surgeons, and as well with an eye toward developing better telemedicine techniques for use in the future in space, but also on the ground. Flight engineer Tom Marshburn had several hours Wednesday setting up the Robonaut in the Destiny Laboratory for use in Thursday experiment operations, when he will telerobotically control R2 by both his voice and by having it mimic his head and hand motions. The Robonaut is an experiment that's just another step in developing better robotic capabilities for use in future space exploration. Flight engineer Alexander Mazurkin devoted the early part of his day on Wednesday to cleaning out ventilation systems in the Russian segment of the station. His afternoon spent testing experiment equipment and taking routine air samples as the crew monitors the environmental quality inside the station. All of the crew members keeping an eye on the approach of the new Progress cargo ship, which is due Friday morning with more than 3 tons of supplies for the station's crew members, as well as for the dozens of experiments that they're working with as they push forward with a mission of science on the International Space Station.